here we are at Helsinki Airport. We just passed security and we have access to that lounge straight ahead. We're leaving from gate 22 at 17:45, so there's time for a little bit of shopping also. So did you find our flight?
Yep. 1745.
1745, Helsinki to Copenhagen, Finnair AY667, and we have the pleasure of flying business class today. A little soup for the lady. Cheers. Good flight, look at the view. Oh, somebody's just landing there. Just focus away from Maro quickly. A plane came. Not that Maro is not important. Hi there.
Nice.
It's good?
It's sparkling.
It's a beautiful lounge here. Lovely view of the runway and the tarmac. And very recommendable lounge to visit. It's a fantastic view from the business lounge. You get to watch the planes up close.
Thank you.
Is that meat sauce or is it soybeans?
That is definitely chili con carne because it has a kidney beans and the...
This is sparkling to your liking.
Very much.
Cheers. Are you ready to fly? Of course she is. She's going business class today. Marlos is way ahead there. I've got my passport in my hand, so hopefully I'm still filming smoothly here.
Enjoy every moment.
And you must walk slow. To the up to your standards.
Got your copy of Ilta Sanoma?
Yes.
Maros Finnish magazine.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen.
Tabloid.
This is the captain speaking. My name is Matt Kasimainen. Welcome aboard.
You're ready to go.
Times she's gonna ask that, she's probably wondering.
What are we doing today? What are we doing today?
Just next to us.
Over here by seat, here we have Marl. Just over there is the business class toilets. So it's easy to get in there.
So this is a little bit different today. The coat hanger that's normally on the seat in front of us. There's no seat in front of us today, we're at the very front of the plane.
But we have the coat hanger. I believe it's a coat hanger anyway.
Seat pocket with the information is in front of us, down here by our feet. We'll look at that later on during the flight. And the tray, the table, is found in the seat. Yeah, we'll pull it up as well as I remember. Such, we'll have a look at that a little bit later in the flight also. Flying pants aren't here today. It's a very good room. Look what I can do with my legs. Now I'm leaning back in my chair. This is what I call a business class. Ah, it is business class. How's the business class model legs doing there?
Even more than my usual flights.
They can stretch themselves up straight on the wall. Even if they had to.
Just put your seatbelt on.
I don't want the seatbelt on already. She's afraid of turbulence on the ground.
Light control, and yeah, the studio's button. Obviously, it's a cool studio. Not much difference.
Takeoff view is going to be a little bit different today because we are in row one in the front of the plane, so there's not going to be any wing view. It's difficult for me to turn around and get any angle of the wing, so I'm just going to film the takeoff similar to this.
Time is 17:45, now 17:44 on my trusty Pulsar watch, and boarding is complete, and we should be taking off on runway 22 according to the captain.
Now, sign is on, so I'm sure pushback is going to start soon.
I think we're pretty comfortable for today, with the seat next to us free. And we'll speak to you later on again.
Cabin crew, please take your door positions. Cabin crew, arm your doors and cross-check. Take flygtikuppen eftermiddagens passagerare också vika bilsättningen. Vi hälsar och välkomna ombord på Finnairs Malmöflyg till Köpenhamn. Vår kapten idag heter Matti Simonen och flygtiden har beräknats att vara 1 timme och 25 minuter. Finnair flyger den här rutten i samarbete med Japan Airlines. Jag får se Pia Tamminen och med min kabinbesättning önskar er en riktigt trevlig flygresa med oss. And a very good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Also from the cabin crew, we would like to welcome you aboard. And as you already heard, our captain today is Mr. Matti Simonen, and the estimated flight time is 1 hour and 25 minutes.
One could get used to this.
Please follow this video closely as we will be demonstrating the safety features of our aircraft. Electronic devices must now be switched off. However, you may continue using handheld personal electronic devices such as smartphones and tablet computers in flight mode. Make sure that your armrest is in the down position. For your own safety, we kindly ask you to avoid spending excess time in the aisles and exit areas during the flight. If the cabin pressure drops, the oxygen masks will automatically appear above your head. Take the nearest seat. Put the jacket over your head. This aircraft has 8 emergency exits, which are all marked with exits. Bearing in mind that it may be behind you, you must adopt the emergency position. The safety features of this aircraft may also be found in the safety card located in the seat pocket. Should you have any questions about safety, please do not hesitate to contact our cabin crew.
Legs are being tied up. Guys, have they on seatbelt on?
Yes. My bag and my camera.
Good. Put the newspaper. And we're taxiing up to runway 22.
Champagne?
Yeah. Never say no.
How can you say?
traffic from yesterday down there. Pity we didn't see any planes. Down on that hill, a lot of spotters down there now. There's full of spotters down on the hill, so this is probably the afternoon is the best time to be there. A lovely view. It won't last long because it's extremely cloudy today. It has been raining. Going up into some dark clouds. Seatbelt because we're going through some thunder clouds. Well, they pretty much look like some kind of thunder clouds. Very heavy. There's a little bit of turbulence. As they call it. There's one of them. There's another one just next to it. So I saw two. Smoke nowadays, if anybody would start, would light up if they didn't say it and if there wasn't a sign. Mara says a curtain just got closed, so now it's just the 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 8 of us here in business class. Airbus A321.
one above there. Always make sure you have one on board. If somebody did get an e-board, I think I'm always going to tell our viewers that you bathed in the bath bag. It's almost full too. Anyway, jokes aside, always make sure there's one, even if you feel well. Because when the need's there, and it's not funny if it's not, if you don't have one. Today, so we're not going to need to buy anything from the Sky Bistro, but you can have a look here at the prices if you were in economy class. So let's skim through it quickly. The stewardess is already coming with the drinks, so I'm going to open this rather quickly to give an idea of what the prices are and what's available.
A toilet, standard toilet. Just explaining what you can throw and what you can't throw when you're done there. Flush buttons over here. Always makes quite a noise. We have two rolls of toilet paper, hot and cold water in the sink, cream, lavender, I think that's soap. It's normally some older toilet there. There's a dirt bin. A plug if you need to shave or have some electronic appliance. Tissue wipes, tissues. And that's me. Hi there. It's a great flight. Glasses up. Looking forward to our in-flight meal, which is about to be served. That's why I'm in a bit of a hurry. There's a space in the lavatory area before I end off. Alright, I better just remember the coat hanger. And the lock. The lock turns the light on as soon as you lock it.
and the airstrip. That concludes the visit to the...
Flushing the toilet on board the aircraft always makes a noise, so today I'm going to flush it for you so you can hear it for yourself. That was actually pretty quiet.
So here we both are. Ready to enjoy our meal. It's looking rather good. We'll go in for a close-up look at it in a second. We've both got a bottle of champagne each. And sparkling water. And the dinner, I can say, is salmon. Is it a custard? What, trout? Yeah, it looks like a rainbow trout, as a matter of fact. We didn't get a menu card, so we don't actually know what we're eating. It would be nice with a menu, you know? Now let's go in for a closer look.
The dessert looks fabulous.
Come on, Aaron. Let's have a look at what you got. Aaron reckons this could be a trout, not just a salmon. I believe it could be red, looks like some kind of rainbow trout. Mm-hmm. What is it on? Is that a pasta or a cabbage trout?
It looks like a cabbage, yeah. Pasta.
And a pasta. And of course we have a champagne over here. And it's real, it's not just sparkling wine, but it would be other places.
A nice ultima thule glass.
There you go. Ultima thule design, finished design glasses. The dessert, blueberries.
Value butter.
And Mara explaining to me that we have value boy. Boy and Finnish is butter, and value is the local dairy company.
Finnish Luopak.
Finnish Luopak, yeah. But not Luopak. Not quite as good as the Danish Luopak. Just to be sure that we got this right, have a look at my dinner. I've spent the weekend at the Hilton Hotel in Helsinki, which is what this is all about. So it's a good thing it's business class. Making these videos is taking its toll on me. But I'll put a brave face up and I'll carry on making the videos. So, without further ado, as I say, we gotta have our dinner. Here we have the dessert. Mara insists that I forgot it. I don't think I forgot it, so just in case. I'm not sure what it is, so she's about to explain what it could be.
It's really like a digestive biscuit bottom with the butter. And then some kind of soppy smooth on the top of a few blueberries.
Did you all catch it? Chocolate.
Yeah.
She's the Finn. She's just been home in Finland.
Chocolate.
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 Yeah. Here we have the serviette. Let's check out the cutlery.
You have to tear it apart because you can't open.
Oh, is that how you do it?
Yeah.
You all know Mara when she opens the packaging on the airport.
Marimekko kiwi.
Marimekko kiwi is the design on the serviette.
A little bit bigger than usual.
That's a rather big serviette.
Oh, it is.
And we got metal knives and forks. I can see there's a butter knife.
Oh, yeah.
There's a normal knife, a fork, a spoon. And we got the normal salt and pepper, a toothpick.
And the design looks like Karelia, Hackman Karelia.
Mara was just checking to see if there was a design. She says it looks like Karelia.
I think it is. Hackman Finland.
Oh, the Finnair logo is at least on the cutlery also. So, should we eat?
Yes.
Good. Enjoy.
And before we start eating, banking left. We're over the sea already, heading towards Sweden.
Then. It was trout.
I think it was trout.
Oh, it was very delicious. Not quite finished yet.
It was cabbage.
And I'll carry on eating. Dessert's waiting.
still enjoying her dessert. Explain what it was.
It was a digestive with butter. Butter? Rich chocolate mousse at the top.
A very nice rich chocolate mousse.
We finished our meals. And it definitely went down well. Very enjoyable and as we said, trout and a bit of cabbage with a creamy sauce is actually quite a good idea.
Lingonberries.
Yeah, and lingonberries added to it. But it would be nice with a menu, letting us know what it is we were eating, just out of interest. Finnair, it was a good meal. It was enjoyable. I think I'm going to be skipping the coffee today. So now they took away my food tray, so I got the chance to show how this armchair packed away seat works. So, the table's here, in the armchair. There's a little handle there, which I get my finger under. I put it forward. Comes out a little picnic table. Go. It's a two-part table. As you can see, there's the cup rest over there that I was showing earlier on. And to make it bigger, I fold it over into two pieces. I'm not sure whether this is a sliding table or not. It's indeed it is. It's quite a sliding table. So there's, now that I see here, plenty of room for more holidays. The way I see it, my stomach should be able to make it out to there, and I'll still be pretty comfortable. Just the same, there's plenty of space in these seats, even on a short-haul flight, and it's very enjoyable to have this extra space and this extra legroom. Before I show the legroom one more time, I'm just going to fold this table away. And Mato's just going to show us how it opens again. Fold it upwards, and I'm going to fold it down back into the chair, all the way down, and bottle's going to close. And that was it. Thank you for the help.
Ladies and gentlemen, we will soon start our approach towards Copenhagen. Within 15 minutes, our captain will switch on the safety bell signs for landing. Whenever you miss the full box in the cabin, we kindly ask you to make sure that you carry your baggage stowed under the seat.
As I said before, I'm thoroughly enjoying this legroom. It's very appreciated. And I could get used to this on long haul flights too. Definitely enjoy it.
Captain is making an announcement. We're probably beginning our descent. Well, that means I better go up and use the lavatory before we land.
It's now 7 o'clock on the trusted pulser. I'm going to adjust it now 1 hour back. It was Denmark time, is 1 hour behind Finnish time. So now we're cloud surfing in a downward direction.
Access is
descending. Here's a blunt. Not much to see out there yet.
And the enjoyment again.
Still got my Kusamui tan. So, downward cloud surfing begins. It's a little bit bouncy too. And we start to see some land down there. It's more than likely Sweden. Is Malmö Airport down there. Oh, it's a little private airport, I'm not quite sure where we are at the moment. There's a sea up there. To the left of your picture. That big landmass straight ahead is the crossing between Denmark's Helsingør and Sweden's Helsingborg. And in a moment on the left of the screen you're going to see a little island come into view. And that island is called Ven, which is a Swedish owned island. Tomorrow and I hope to go visiting this summer for a day trip.
Cabin crew landing in less than 10 minutes.
See, way out there in the distance is probably the DFDS Oslo ferry, big ferry cruise ship. Trying to zoom, not sure if you can see anything. Maybe in this area of the picture if I'm zooming in the right area. But we'll zoom out again. And there comes Ven. Over there to the left. Sun is shining nicely over Ven today.
Oh, the difference is Ven over there.
Yeah, it is.
Nice view from. Can you see the Oslo ship over there? Going up through the channel.
Exactly.
There's another passenger line over there.
Yeah, you can see the turning torso or something.
I don't think this is turning towards, this isn't Malmö yet. Now we turn, now we turn towards Malmö, but we'll probably fly over the sea so we won't see Malmö. But as I said, that's Ven straight ahead. And that little island, I'm not quite sure, well not the island, the little harbour area down below. Not quite sure what that is. And the land on the other side, that's Copenhagen or it's Denmark. Lovely turn. My ears are pretty blocked at this stage. I was holding my nose, if you can hear that, I'm gonna blow now. And it worked. It's a lovely view, isn't it?
Yeah, a lot of windmills also there.
Yeah, the windmills have plenty of. Beautiful evening for a landing. There's not very much wind, at least from what I can see in the sea. A little bit of foam, but normally there's a lot more, so it's rather calm. And the captain's pointing the nose down a little bit more. We are on final approach now. Just coming into the left of the picture now is one of the little islands. There's one straight ahead also. Center of the screen. Some of these are yacht clubs.
I believe they're privately owned. So
if your flaps are down, you should be able to hear it on the videos. I'm going to keep quiet for a little bit now.
I think we are flying straight over the bridge.
The windmills are straight ahead. Apparently, I wasn't going to be quiet for a while. I must just tell a little bit more. That's the windmill park out there in the sea.
We're ready to land here. Got our noses glued to the window. Good thing is to have a camera, as I have, because you get the window seen every time. Hooked in, it's perfect. Maro, you can lean over and see if you can see it.
I can see the videos at home.
She watches it at home. But anyway, I better hurry up and point this camera outwards.
So we're back again, pointing the camera out the window. There's a windmill park out there to the right. Coming into Copenhagen, we're going straight in to the runway. I don't think there's going to be very much maneuvering from here. You can see the towers of Copenhagen. If I quickly zoom a little bit, you'll see it better. And we are on short final now. I'm going to zoom out, prepare to hold this camera steady for the landing. Spotting position down there. And here's Copenhagen Airport. We're going to be landing in a couple of seconds. It's a Dreamliner leaving and a touchdown. One Norwegian Dreamliner just over to the right and a Qatar Airways Dreamliner. But you go full brakes. He wants to make this turn here. Well, it's this taxiway, I believe. Oh, it would have been quite a sharp turn. That was quite a break, isn't it? Something went rolling.
Hyvät matkustajat, tervetuloa Kööpenhaminaan. Olkaa hyvä, istukaa vielä paikoillaan ja turvavyöt kiinnitettyinä, kunnes sitä osoittava merkkivalo on sammutettu ja kone on täysin pysähtynyt. Ja olette varovaisia avatessanne matkatavarahyllyjä
lukkuja, ettei ole tavaroita päässyt putoamaan. It's where we normally go spotting also. Watch our videos. Our playlist for Copenhagen Airport, you'll see a video of
Kööpenhamn.
A lot of aeroplanes landing there. Three more coming in.
Vi hoppas att ni trivdes ombord med oss idag. Vi säger tack för att ni har fått och önskar er en riktigt trevlig fortsättning på kvällen. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to Copenhagen. Please remain seated with your seatbelts fastened until the seatbelt signs have been switched off and the plane has come to a complete stop. And please be careful when opening the overhead lockers as items may fall out. We hope that you have had a pleasant flight with us. We say thank you, welcome again, and do wish you a nice evening.
SAS retro aircraft.
Cabin crew, prepare for takeoff.
Cabin crew, please take it over, systems.
Looks like we have a parking place close to this whirling Airbus. Enjoyable flight, this business class flight for a change. We hope you enjoyed flying with us. We're not going to leave you behind quite yet. We're just going to walk up the aircraft and take you on a walk with us down to the luggage area, and then we'll end the video off for this time.
engines off, seat belts.
Cabin crew, disembark doors and cross check.
Kiitos paljon. Bye bye. And we're back in Copenhagen. Hey, look at that little jet there. Look at that little blue one there.
Yeah. Let's zoom in on that BMI.
So now we're gonna make our way down to the luggage. It's quite a walk from here.
Arrival gate is.
Can't even see what arrival gate this is.
You leave from here too, then
you can. No, I haven't left from further. This is gate A17.
That's where I live.
That's gate A17. So, let's make our way.
C34.
So Maro will lead the way with the luggage. We're gonna have one last look at our aircraft for today. Maro, just wait a sec. That's our aircraft for today. Airbus. That was a good flight. Airport's busy at this time of the evening. See some takeoffs there in the distance. Let's go this way. We've got a SES Airbus parked just out here. So, if you lead the way with the speeder. Wait, one sec, Maro. This is the, what I call the Black Ops aircraft. It's a LC Express. Would love to have a flight on this aircraft. It flies to Sønderborg in Denmark. It's very unique because of its very black paint. Look at that. At the same time, we got DAT, Danish Air Transport Company. It also flies regional here in Denmark, among other places, to the sunny island of Bornholm, the Danish island of Bornholm. So let's carry on back down and get our luggage. So I just left here on Friday. I did a solo flight without Maro up to Helsinki, where I met Maro. I'll probably make a video of my solo flight from here to Helsinki, also with Finnair Business Class, if I haven't already uploaded it to our channel. It will be on the way. If I have uploaded it, check out our channel to find it. Finnair Business Class to Helsinki. You have to take a shortcut through the food court.
Atlantic Airways 459. Terminus kontakt med det samme til udgang. Det er
So on my business class flight to Helsinki, I had the pleasure of spending some time before my flight up there in the aviator lounge, which they call the Copenhagen Airport apartment. It was quite a good experience. That will also be included in my video of my flight to Helsinki. You can see just ahead is the baggage claim area. So down we go. Put my hand luggage can get past here. Yes. I'm dragging behind me here as I'm filming. We have arrived in the baggage claims area. The first thing he's got to do down here is to check on the screen to see what conveyor belt our luggage will be coming from. It'll also be interesting to see how quickly our luggage comes now that we're flying business class today. If it really does get a priority or if it takes as long as usual. 15 minutes. Wow, what number?
Three.
And the baggage is already on the conveyor belt. We need a trolley, Maro. Well, it's not just our luggage, there's luggage from Stockholm, Istanbul and Helsinki.
Thanks for joining Mara and I on this business class flight from Helsinki to Copenhagen. If you enjoyed the video, please leave us a like and a comment down below. And if you haven't already done so, please subscribe to our channel. See you on our next flight.